Into each life some rain must fall.
So, here's the deal, guys. As much fun as it is playing with exotic hi-fi components, the products that truly excite me are the ones that are easy to buy, the ones that represent great value for the money, and products that serve as a great ambassador for what hi-fi listening is all about. And that's why I'm so excited to introduce to you all these Sony Bookshelf speakers. Their model number is the SS-SC5, and they're part of the Sony Core series, which is designed to serve basically as their entry into their home audio lineup. So what we're going to do is take a closer look at these speakers before I tell you about how they sound. So to begin, what you're looking at is something that's pretty unique for the price point, and that's because this is going to be a three-way design. We have two tweeters and a woofer. The topmost tweeter is going to be a 3/4 inch super tweeter, which extends all the way up to 50 kilohertz. Then we have a 1 inch soft dome tweeter, followed by a 5 inch foamed mica cellulose woofer. So this is an interesting woofer because I believe it's exclusive to just Sony, and it's designed to be very lightweight so it can move very quickly, but at the same time to be very rigid so it can handle decent amounts of power output without actually distorting. So overall, it's a very unique speaker because most of the times you'll never see a super tweeter. It's something at this price point, which if I haven't mentioned it already, which I don't believe I have, they're around $149 a pair. That's what they sell for on average on places like Amazon and through Best Buy. And this makes them just very accessible, even for somebody who's working a job while in high school. Now on the back here, you'll see a port. This is supposed to be a bass reflex design. We actually have a pair of pretty decent five-way binding posts, so you can hook them up via bare wire, spade, or banana connection just fine. But overall, these speakers are they're reasonably well made for what they are. They're around 87 dB efficient and sport a 6 ohm nominal load, which you would think makes them very power hungry, but they're actually still pretty easy to drive, although they'll sound a little more muted compared to the rest of their competitors in a big box store. And that leads me to how they sound. Alright guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this review down into two sections. And the first section is going to go to those of you who maybe you're not an audiophile, you just saw these products and you want to get a little bit more information first before you commit to the purchase. And after that, I'm going to switch to the audiophile section where I get to use phrases and terminologies that audiophiles are familiar with. So first and foremost, to the real world person, the first question you're going to have is, are these speakers actually that good for $149 a pair? And the answer is, hell yeah, they are. These are great speakers for the money. But here's the thing. If you're interested in them, my best advice would be to go ahead and buy them from an authorized retailer that offers a good trial period, because going to a store like Best Buy and auditioning them there, it's not going to do you much good, because a lot of these big box locations, not only do they sound like crap, but here's what's going to happen. You're going to walk into the store, you're going to listen to Klipsch and it's going to sound bright and dynamic, you're going to listen to Polk Audio and it's going to sound nice and warm, and then when you go to these speakers, they're going to sound flat and almost lifeless, and unfortunately, that's this speaker's best strength, working against it in an environment like a big box retailer, because when you get right down to it, these speakers are all about quality over quantity. In fact, that's who it's for. If you're saying, hey, I want a small speaker that'll make it sound like I'm front row center at a rock concert, these are definitely not going to be for you. But if you're saying, hey, I want something that's quality over quantity, I have a music collection or I have a collection of movies, I want to go through and hear details that I haven't heard before, especially if you're coming from a sound bar, a home theater and a box setup, or some old speakers, then these are going to be a great solution for you, because these speakers are all about giving you effortless detail, effortless clarity. Again, it's a quality over quantity proposition. Not to say that they can't get loud. They actually can get surprisingly loud for what they are. But again, this is going to be more for somebody who says, I want a great quality listening experience. Moreover, I want something that sounds good at a variety of volumes, not just loud. I want something that sounds great even at low listening levels. Maybe you're in an apartment, maybe you have friends or family around and you don't want to disturb them. This is going to be a great solution. It sounds great in a desktop environment, it sounds great on a wall, and it also sounds great if you treat them as a normal pair of hi-fi speakers. Speaking of which, it'll also sound good on a wide variety of component types, whether you're running a typical AV receiver or whether, of course, you're running typical hi-fi components. And also, as a nice bonus on top, I come to find that they actually sound pretty good on a wide variety of music, whether it's rap, electronic, whether it's dance, pop music, jazz, classical. It sounds pretty consistently good across all those varieties of music. And overall, this is going to be for somebody who says, look, I want something that is affordable, but I want a maturity to the sound. I'm all about resolution. I'm all about a clean presentation. That's what these speakers give you. And now let's switch to the audiophile. All right, my audiophile brothers and sisters, the first thing that you need to know is if you were to bring these home, expect to hear a presentation that's ever so slightly on the forward side of neutral. The first thing that's going to jump at you is the treble, and this for a few good reasons. First and foremost is due to the voicing, but second of all, because it's so damned good. This is easily the best top end that I've heard from a set of speakers below the $300 price point, hands down. Yes, that includes Pioneer and ELAC and all of the regular suspects. Sony knocked it out the park with this configuration because in a lot of respects, it emulates the ideal kind of presentation that a lot of us have in mind when it comes to hi-fi, something that has this effortless clarity to it, something that reveals subtle details within a recording with relative ease, but at the same time is easy to listen to. In fact, you can listen to poor recordings and not be just driven completely out of the room, and that's exactly what these things are about. Now, to be fair, everything that I'm saying is relative to their price point. If you were to put them in an anechoic chamber, I'm sure you'd see peaks and valleys here and there, something that wouldn't be acceptable on a pair of, say, $1,000 loudspeakers. But for this kind of speaker at this price point, it is fantastic top end. I absolutely love it. Then you have the mid-range. The mid-range is great, maybe ever so slightly on the thin side of neutral, but also very enjoyable. When listening to acoustic pieces, for example, I'm surprised by how authentic the tone is, especially for the price point. This is a very fairly accurate speaker for the money. In fact, what's so cool is I actually use these speakers to go through a bunch of different components just for fun, really. And I was surprised by how accurately these speakers were able to portray the sound of something like the Heat Elixir and the Parasound Gear and my Vista Audio Spark. They did far better than I expected in that regard. So they're actually fairly transparent for what they are. Being able to tell the difference between recordings, FLAC files, MP3s, high res, they actually do a very respectable job, especially if you're sensitive to stuff like that. Now, let's talk about the bass. The bass is going to be, well, it just depends on what you connect to them. Let me explain. On the Vista Audio Spark and on the Parasound Gear, the bass was incredibly tight and clean to the point of maybe sounding like there was just some density kind of lacking from the sound. But I noticed that when I connected them to the Heat Elixir integrated amplifier, that bass was right there, it was full, and I can understand why one reviewer said that he thought these speakers sounded much more full than his significantly more expensive B&W speakers. I get that now. It just depends on what you pair them up with. But by and large, these are fantastic sounding speakers. The imaging is great. In fact, you'll get the best sound by not even towing them in. I mean, that's how wonderful they are at throwing a huge soundstage, which pretty reasonable depth to go with it. So overall, just a great sounding speaker, but still, they're not perfect. So let's go over some of those imperfections right now. All right, so it's pretty obvious that at $149 a pair, they're not going to be perfect. While they sound fantastic at moderate to low listening volumes, if you're the kind of person that really likes to jam out at loud listening levels, then the Sonys are going to have just a little bit of an issue. And I say that because the top end that I love so much begins to get a little bit more peaky at higher volumes, which honestly is pretty common with most affordable speakers, but it's going to be particularly noticeable with the Sonys just because the top end is so damn good otherwise. Also, the bass. The bass is going to be a mixed experience. It just depends on what you connect to these speakers. With the Vista Audio Spark and the Parasound Gear, I noticed the bass was just okay. But when I connected it to a Sony receiver or the Heat Elixir integrated amp, it is fantastic. So you just need to experiment around and see what works best for you. But otherwise, these are damn good speakers, and that leads me to my final thoughts. Look, guys, I know that this is a pretty enthusiastic review, but honestly, I think the enthusiasm is 100% warranted with these speakers. And I say that because they do a great job of capturing what this is all about. Because if you're coming from a soundbar or PC speakers or old speakers or home theater and box kit, whatever. You're going to get these, you're going to hook them up, and you're going to notice information in your music and movies that you've never heard before, or at least it's going to be revealed to you in a way that'll allow you to reconnect with the media that you love. And that's what this whole thing is all about. And the fact that Sony's done it in this way and at this price point, as I said earlier, at a price that even a high school kid could afford, I think that's exciting. I think that's something worth getting enthusiastic about. Now, to be clear, I'm not overhyping these speakers, all right? I'm not saying that these things are better than other products at 3 times the price and 4 times the price or 10 times the price. I'm merely saying that they're pretty damn good for what they are, and they're definitely worthy of someone's consideration. Anyways, guys, that's just my take on these speakers. As always, thanks for watching, and until next time, peace. Thank you.